Enoxaparin is a low molecular weight heparin used for the prophylaxis of deep vein thrombosis and ischemic complications of unstable angina and non-Q-wave myocardial infarction. In this video, let's find found. What is enoxaparin? What is enoxaparin used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking enoxaparin? How does enoxaparin work? How to use enoxaparin? What is enoxaparin? Enoxaparin sodium, sold under the brand name Lovenox among others, is an anticoagulant medication. It is used to treat and prevent deep vein thrombosis and pulmonary embolism, including during pregnancy and following certain types of surgery. It is also used in those with acute coronary syndrome and heart attacks. Enoxaparin was first made in 1981 and approved for medical use in 1993. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. Enoxaparin is made from heparin. In 2020, it was the 350th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 500,000 prescriptions. What is enoxaparin used for? Enoxaparin is indicated for the prevention of ischemic complications in unstable angina and in non-Q-wave myocardial infarction. It is indicated in conjunction with percutaneous intervention and or other treatment for the management of acute ST elevation myocardial infarction. Enoxaparin is also indicated in the prophylaxis of DVT in abdominal surgery, hip replacement, knee replacement, or medical patients with severely restricted mobility during acute illness. Additionally, enoxaparin is indicated for the inpatient treatment of DVT with or without pulmonary embolism and the treatment of outpatient T without pulmonary embolism. Contraindication. Known hypersensitivity to enoxaparin, urticaria, anaphylactoid reactions, anaphylaxis, or any heparin products. Active major bleeding, such as gastrointestinal bleed. History of heparin-induced thrombocytopenia within the past 100 days or presence of circulating antibodies. Side effects. Uncommon, less than 1%. In people with unstable angina or non-Q-wave myocardial infarction. Atrial fibrillation, heart failure, lung edema, pneumonia, greater than or equal to 0.5% v. common, greater than 1%. Thrombocytopenia. I.e. can be associated with heparin-induced thrombocytopenia, 0.5 to 5.0% of persons treated for at least 5 days. Elevations in serum aminotransferases, 5.9% to 6.1%. In people undergoing abdominal or colorectal surgery. Bleeding, anemia, ecchymosis, greater than or equal to 2%. In persons undergoing hip or knee replacement. Fever, nausea, anemia, edema, peripheral edema, greater than or equal to 2%, in persons with severely restricted mobility during acute illness. Dyspnea, cytopenia, confusion, diarrhea, nausea, greater than or equal to 2%. In people being treated for deep vein thrombosis. Injection site hemorrhage, injection site pain, hematuria, greater than or equal to 2%. Mechanism of action. Enoxaparin binds to antithrombin 3, a serine protease inhibitor, forming a complex that irreversibly inactivates factor XA, which is frequently used to monitor anticoagulation in the clinical setting. Following factor XA inactivation, enoxaparin is released and binds other antithrombin molecules. Factor IIA, thrombin, is directly inhibited by enoxaparin, however with less potency than unfractionated heparin, UFH. Due to the cascade of effects resulting from enoxaparin binding, thrombin is unable to convert fibrinogen to fibrin and form a clot, preventing thromboembolic event. Mechanism of action. Enoxaparin binds to antithrombin 3, a serine protease inhibitor, forming a complex that irreversibly inactivates factor XA, which is frequently used to monitor anticoagulation in the clinical setting. Following factor XA inactivation, enoxaparin is released and binds other antithrombin molecules. Factor IIA, thrombin, is directly inhibited by enoxaparin, however with less potency than unfractionated heparin, UFH. Due to the cascade of effects resulting from enoxaparin binding, Thrombin is unable to convert fibrinogen to fibrin and form a clot, preventing thromboembolic events. Half-life. The half-life of enoxaparin is about 4 hours after a single dose administered subcutaneously and about 7 hours after several doses. Dose. Deep vein thrombosis, prophylaxis. Patients at risk undergoing abdominal surgery or hip or knee replacement surgery, as well as patients with severely restricted mobility during acute illness. Abdominal surgery. 40 mg SCQ-day, initiate 2 hours actively. Knee or hip replacement surgery. 30 mg SCQ-12-HR, initiate therapy 12 to 24 hours postoperatively, continue for 10 days, or up to 35 days postoperatively, or risk of DVT reduced significantly, or patient is on anticoagulant therapy. For hip replacement surgery, may administer 40 mg SCQ-day, initiate 9 to 15 hours preoperatively, continue for 10 days, or up to 35 days postoperatively, or until risk of DVT reduced significantly, or patient is on anticoagulant therapy. Medical patients restricted mobility. 40 mg SCQ-day, continue until risk of DVT reduced significantly, 6 to 11 days, or patient is on anticoagulant therapy. Dosing considerations. Abdominal surgery, duration of administration is 7 to 10 days, up to 12 days, administered in clinical trials or until risk of DVT has diminished. Knee or hip replacement surgery, duration of administration is 7 to 10 days, up to 14 days has been administered in clinical trials or until risk of DVT has diminished. Medical patients with restricted mobility, duration administration is 6 to 11 days, up to 14 days has been administered in clinical trials. Deep vein thrombosis, treatment. Inpatient treatment. Acute DVT with or without PE, when administered in conjunction with warfarin sodium. 1 mg per kilogram SCQ-12-HR, or 1.5 mg per kilogram SCQ-day, administer at same time each day. Outpatient treatment. Acute DVT without PE, when administered in conjunction with warfarin sodium. 1 mg per kilogram SCQ-12-HR, unstable angina and non-PMI. Prophylaxis of ischemic complications of unstable angina and non-Q-wave myocardial infarction, when concurrently administered with aspirin. 1 mg per kilogram SCQ-12-HR. Regimen includes aspirin, 100 to 325 mg/day. Safety advice. Enoxaparin is a FDA pregnancy category B drug, which means enoxaparin is not expected to cause harm to an unborn baby when used during pregnancy. That's all the information about enoxaparin we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.